Hey everyone, so welcome to the fifth lecture on the course Ordinary Differential Equations. So today we are going to see the fourth method on how to find the solutions to the first order linear differential equations. So till now we have seen three methods: variable separable method, reduction to variable separable method, and the exactness method. So whenever you see a first order linear differential equation, you first try to see whether these three methods can be applied or not. If they can't be applied, then we go for the fourth method, which is called as an integrating factor method. Okay, so what do we saw in our previous lecture? We saw that whenever you have a first order linear differential equation of the form mdx plus ndy equal to 0, then when do I say this is an exact differential equation? If there exists a differentiable function u, if its total derivative is equal to mdx plus ndy. And when such a u exists, for that we saw a theorem which was the necessary and sufficient condition, and the theorem was: whenever your m with respect to y is equal to n with respect to x, we say it is an exact differential equation and we can find the function u. And whenever they are not equal, we say it's a non-exact differential equation. So that's what we saw. But now there are some non-exact differential equations which can be converted into exact differential equations, and once it is exact, we know how to solve. So then the question is, how a non-exact differential equation can be converted into an exact differential equation? And to do this transition, this is the one which will help us. So integrating factors will help you to convert a non-exact differential equation into an exact differential equation, and as soon as it becomes exact, we know how to find the solution. Okay, so what is the agenda for today's talk? So the agenda for today's talk is, we will see what are integrating factors. I will tell you two ways to find integrating factors. Well, I have personally seen six methods to find the integrating factors. But then since I am following the book by Kreyszig and he talks only about two ways, so I'll be talking only about two ways to find the integrating factors. Well, those who are interested, they can definitely Google it out. But yeah, two ways are, yeah, fine, it's sufficient for us. And at the end, I will take some examples so that the concept will be clear. So let's see what are integrating factors. Now, what do you mean by an integrating factor? So it's a function f such that if you multiply this function to a non-exact differential equation, it will convert that non-exact differential equation into an exact differential equation. So whenever if you are able to find such a function which do this transition, nice transition, then we call such a function to be an integrating factor. Okay, so now the question is, how to find this integrating factor? So let's see those two methods to find integrating factors. Okay, so now this is the scenario. We have a first order linear differential equation and we have that it is a non-exact differential equation. Okay, now what do we do is, we first, so method one says, you first try to calculate the quantity my minus nx and you divide this by 1 by n. So you find out this quantity if this term is independent of y. Okay, if this term is independent of y, that means what? This term will either contain only the function of x or it will contain constants and the terms of x, both are fine. So I will say if this term is independent of y, so let me call this as r of x, since it is independent of y. So if this term is independent of y, then your integrating factor is e raised to integration of r of x dx, if this term is independent of y. If this term contains y, then this won't be an integrating factor. So what you will do, you will go for the second method. Now what you will do over here is, you calculate n with respect to x minus m with respect to y and divide by m. Now if this term is independent of x, that means what? This term will contain either the terms of y or only constant. So let me denote this, and whatever the term we get, let me denote it by r of y. So if this is the scenario, in that case your integrating factor is, this is your integrating factor. And if suppose this contains the term of y and this contains the term of x, that means you are not able to find the integrating factor. In that scenario, we will go for another method. So we will play with these two methods to find the integrating factor. Now let me take a couple of examples so that the method will be clear. Okay, before starting the example, one can ask whether the integrating factors are unique. That means given a non-exact differential equation, can we find only one integrating factor or can we find more than one integrating factor? So the answer is integrating factors need not be unique. Okay, for one non-exact differential equation, you may have more than one integrating factors. So let me take that example first and then we will come to these examples. So take this as an example. Well, this can be solved by variable separable, but I want to give you an example that integrating factors are not unique. So now this is a first order linear differential equation. My m is 2y, my n is 3x, and clearly my m with respect to y, which is 2, is not equal to n with respect to x, which is 3. So obviously it is a non-exact differential equation. Now what you do is you take f equals 1 upon xy. And we will see that if I multiply this differential equation by 1 upon xy, then this will become an exact differential equation. Okay, so what do I get? I get, if I multiply f with this differential equation, what do I get is 2 upon x dx plus 3 upon y dy equal to 0. Now what is my m? This is my m and this is my n. Now what is m with respect to y? 0, because there is no y over here. What is n with respect to x? That's also 0 because there is no x over here. So therefore this is an integrating factor, because when I'm multiplying this function to this differential equation, it is becoming an exact differential equation. Now let me give you one more integrating factor. You take f equal to 1 upon x raised to 1 by 3. You take this as your f, you multiply your differential equation by this function and verify, I won't be doing over here, but you make sure you verify that after multiplying f to this differential equation, it is becoming an exact differential equation. And let me know in the comment section whether it is exact or not. So this example shows that integrating factors are not unique. You can find more than one integrating factor. Okay, let's go towards the next set of examples. Okay, now consider this as your differential equation, first order linear differential equation, x plus y sin y dx plus x sin y plus cos y into dy equals 0. Now what is my m? The coefficient of dx. My n is coefficient of dy. And one can say that m with respect to y, here you apply the product rule, and n with respect to x, both are not equal. So therefore this is your non-exact differential equation. Now as soon as you have a non-exact differential equation, what we do is we try to use our integrating factor technique. So what method 1 says? The method 1 says you try to find the quantity 1 upon n into m with respect to y minus n with respect to x. And if this quantity is independent of y, then whatever answer you have, taking its e raised to integration will be the integrating factor. Now in this case, let's find out the value. So in this case, my r of x is coming out to be 1 upon x sin y plus cos y, x plus y cos y. And as we can see, this is not independent of y. So therefore, because the terms of y are coming into the picture, so therefore I can't use method 1 to find the integrating factor. So what I will do, I will go for the second method. So what does the second method says? You calculate 1 upon m nx minus my, and this should be independent of x. So let's see, what do we get over here? We get 1 upon x plus y sin y, which was my m, into nx minus my. So sin y will go away, I get minus of x plus y cos y, and here also x plus y will go away, I will get minus cot y. So yes, this term is independent of y. Great, so now I can find the integrating factor. So what is the integrating factor? E raised to integration of r of y. So e raised to integration of minus cot of y dy. Now what is integration of cot? Ln of sine. So here if I put ln of sine, so what I get is sine y inverse, because e raised to ln x is x. So integrating factor is 1 upon sine y. So now you multiply your non-exact differential equation with 1 upon sine y. So what do we get is x plus y, because sine y was here. When I multiply by sine y inverse, that sine y will go away. Here we had x sine y. So dividing by sine y, only x will remain. Here we had cos y, cos upon sine is nothing but cot. Now this is my new differential equation. And now if you observe here, what is my m with respect to y? My m is what? X plus y. So m with respect to y is 1. What is my n with respect to x? Again, this is my n, and n with respect to x is 1. So great. So as you can see, if I multiply by sine y inverse, I am getting the exact differential equation. And once it is exact, you know how to find the solution, right? So what you do is, you call your dou by u by dou by x, the two equations which you get, dou by u by dou by x, it will come out to be x plus y, dou by u by dou by y equal to x plus cot y. This I have done precisely in my previous lecture. So if you have missed my previous lecture, make sure you go through this method. Okay, so it's a very important method and very important algorithm, I would say. Okay, so this is what we have, and now you integrate this with respect to x, you differentiate, you compare, you again integrate, do all these things, and at the end you will get the solution as, so this is what you get. So this is the general solution you get for the linear differential equation. Make sure you do this calculation, and if you get stuck anywhere, do comment in the comment section. I would be happy to answer that. So this is what the solution is to the given differential equation. Now let's go for the second example. Okay, now for the second example, I won't be doing the calculations, but I will give you the answers for the in-between steps. So if I take this as my new differential equation, first order linear, m is the coefficient of dx, n is the coefficient of dy. You calculate m with respect to y and n with respect to x, you will observe that they are not equal. And since they are not equal, therefore this is a non-exact linear differential equation. Now what do? You find first r of x. And when you will find r of x, it will come out to be 1 upon x, the method 1 which I said. And now since this is independent of y, therefore your integrating factor will be e raised to integration of this. And e raised to integration of this will come out to be x only. So this is your integrating factor. You multiply this differential equation by x. So you will get 3x square y minus xy square dx plus x square into x minus y dy equal to 0. Now you check that the new differential equation will be an exact differential equation. Show your work, and then again use our previous algorithm to find the solution u. And your solution will come out to be x cube y minus x square y square by 2 upon c. So make sure you do the calculations, and if you get stuck, comment in the comment section, I will answer your doubts. Now before ending the talk, let me give you these two homework problems. Take these two problems, both are non-exact differential equations. You verify first, try to find integrating factor, method 1, method 2. These are the integrating factors you should get. I mean, I hope my calculations are right. If you are getting something else, comment in the comment section. And at the end, also comment what are the answers for both the questions so that other people can also verify. So this was about integrating factor method. I hope the method is clear. If you have any concerns, you can ask me. And do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you.